Hello everyone, welcome to MESS e-learning channel. In this lecture today, we'll solve another problem based on a parallel force system. So this is the given problem on parallel force system wherein all the forces are directed along x-axis. Now, and what data given to us is the radius of this circle is one, that is it is a unit circle. And what we have to find is we have to locate the resultant force with respect to O. Now, if all the forces are parallel and directed along x-axis, even the resultant here will be directed along x-axis. So let us find the resultant first. So our resultant would be, our first step would be to find the resultant, as we know from the previous lecture, that would be equal to summation of F. Now, why only summation of F? Because all the forces are parallel to each other, directed along same axis, will be equal to. Now, this force is going backwards, so according to sign convention, it is negative. So it is minus 100. Similarly, this would be minus 80. This is also in the backward direction, so minus 50. And this force is also, this force is going in the positive direction, so it would be plus 150. So if we calculate this, we would get the answer to be minus 80 Newton, that is our resultant force. So now whenever we have to locate any force, any resultant force with respect to a point, we need to find the moment about that point because we have to apply the Varignon's theorem. So to find the moment, we need the perpendicular distances to all the forces that is being given to us. So if this is my force, if I consider this force, my perpendicular distance to this force from O would be this. So we need to find the distance there in order to find the moment. So similarly, we have to find this distance, and this distance. So let me simplify the diagram first. So let's say I draw this. So I'll place the forces later, but in this axis we'll be placing our forces. So let us find the distances first. So if I consider this triangle here, that is O, this and this for this force. So I have this distance to be 1 because it is the radius of the circle is 1, and I have this angle to be 30. So I have to find the opposite distance, and we know that sine theta is equal to opposite upon hypotenuse. So if I take sine theta is equal to opposite upon hypotenuse, we have the hypotenuse and we have the theta too. So it would be sine 30 is equal to the opposite distances we have to find, and the hypotenuse is 1. So what we get the distance to be, if we say the distance what we get here will be 0.5. That is the opposite distance. So at 0.5 we'll have our 80 Newton force. Similarly, if I take this also, I would get my force to be, this is also 30, this is 1, and this is the opposite distance. So similarly I would get this distance, let's say I say it is x and this is y. So my x here is 0.5. So therefore y also would be equal to 0.5. Now let us come to the other side. So we have 100 newton force here. So if I consider this triangle, I have 60 degree and opposite side we have to find, and this is similarly 1. So it would become as sine 60 equals to my opposite upon hypotenuse. Let's say this is P distance and this is Q distance. Okay, so this is P upon my hypotenuse is 1, that is this distance. So if I calculate, my P would become 0.866, small p. Then the next is my Q. So it is similarly, I have here 45 degree and opposite to that side is Q. So my, it would be sine 45 equals to q upon 1, and therefore q would be equal to, if I calculate, it would be 0.707, all in meters. So if I have to place all the forces, so my x is at 0.5 meters, that is 80 Newton. So it is going backwards. So let's say this is my point O. At 0.5 distance, my force will be going backwards. So this is 80 Newton. And the distance here would be 0.5 meters. The next force is 100 Newton, which is also going backwards, 100 Newtons, and the distance from O here would be 0.866 meters. The next force here, my Y is 0.5 meters, and this force is going outwards, so this would become like this, that is 150 Newtons, and my distance from O would become 0.5 meters. Then the last force here is 50 Newtons, so here it would come somewhat like this, because the Q distance is 0.707. So from O, my distance would be 0.707 meters, and the force is 50 Newtons. So this is the simplified version of this diagram. As we know all the forces and their perpendicular distances from O, now we can directly move on to finding the moment part. So my next step after resultant would be to find the moment. So what we have to do is we have to find moment about O. So to find moment about O, it would be equal to summation of all the forces into their perpendicular distances. So force into distance. So the first force is 100 here, and from O the distance is 0.866, which is the perpendicular distance to this force. And now to check the sign convention of moment, we need to see if it is clockwise or anticlockwise. So I keep my thumb here. If we see, this is an anticlockwise force. So if this is anticlockwise, we consider anticlockwise as positive. So this would be 100 into the distance is 0.866. Then the next force is 80 Newton, which is also in the anticlockwise direction, and the perpendicular distances from O is 0.5. So this would be also positive. So it would be 80 into 0.5. Then our next force here is 150 Newton. So from O, if we see the direction, this is also, if you see, it is anticlockwise. So if this is going anticlockwise, this would be also become positive. And so this would be plus 150 into the perpendicular distance from O is 0.5. The last force here is 50 Newton. From here, if we see, this is in the clockwise direction. So the clockwise direction, that is why negative, and the perpendicular distance from O is 0.707. So it is negative 50 into 0.707. Now, all the forces are done. So if we calculate the value, it would become 166.25 Newton meter, and the value comes out to be negative, so it is in the anticlockwise direction. Now here also, for the resultant, if I have to mention the direction, we can also write this as 80 Newton in the backward direction. Now I have the direction and the magnitude for resultant force, I have the moment. So now I can directly move on to locate the resultant force. So to locate the resultant force, our third step would be to apply Varignon's theorem. So now, according to Varignon's theorems, it is moment of resultant force about a point would be equal to summation of all the forces about that same point. So this would be R into D, that is resultant into the perpendicular distance of that resultant, equals to moment of force about F of all the forces about point O is this. So that is 166.25, and the resultant value here is 80 into D is equal to 166.25. So my D would become 2.078 meters. Now, why did I not consider the negative sign? Because that is just to denote the direction of the resultant force. So we have to take it as the magnitude itself here. Now, the last step would be to locate the resultant force. So I'll draw the same diagram like this, the simplified version of it. So I have, this is my point O. Now, the distance is 2.078, and this is the resultant is coming to be negative, that is in the backward direction, and we have the direction of moment to be anti-clockwise. So if this is my point O, and if I have to draw the force backward, if I draw it here, that is the resultant is equal to 80 Newton in the backward direction. If I draw it here, this distance would become the D, that is equal to 2.078 meters. And if you see, it is in the anti-clockwise direction. So if you draw it here, then if you see, if you actually rotate your hand and see, it would become clockwise. That is why this is the appropriate position for resultant force R and the distance from the point O, which is being given. So in this lecture, we saw how to solve a problem based on a parallel force system and how to locate the resultant from a given point. Hope you understood. Thank you.